It is late summer 1536 in the small market town of Louth in rural Lincolnshire. Rumours abound that the King's commissioners are en route to demolish parish churches and seize the church silver. Tensions are rising. The town's vicar, Thomas Kendall, gives a rousing sermon, leading a group of local men to barricade themselves in the church for its protection. A leader emerges, the shoemaker Nicholas Melton, who would become known as Captain Cobbler. Representatives of the bishop arrive in the town on unrelated business and are detained. Later that day, two of the king's agents overseeing the dissolution of a nearby nunnery are also captured. So far, just a bit of small town trouble. The following morning, a small group from Louth travel to the neighbouring town of Caster. Here they find more of the king's commissioners, and determined to discover if the rumours of the fate of their church are true, they pursue and capture them as well. By that evening, word of events in Louth is spreading. The local gentry, the class below the nobility, are held in the town, but one of them escapes and gets a message to the king. Meanwhile, inspired by Louth's example, a similar rising occurs in nearby Horncastle. Dr. Raine, the Chancellor of the Diocese of Lincoln, is found at Bolingbroke by the rebels. He is brought to Horncastle and is lynched by his own clergy. By now, the rebels have grown in number to several thousand. They enter Lincoln and occupy the cathedral. Here the rebels draw up their list of demands. These are watered down by the reluctant gentry, who have been compelled, so they later claim, to help lead the rising. Instead of demands for no peacetime taxes, the full restoration of church property, and for Cromwell and his circle to be handed over to the rebels, they limit their complaint to a specific tax, warn of the harm to their communities if the monasteries are closed, and comment snidely on the influence of councillors of low birth. The king's representative, Charles Brandon, the Duke of Suffolk, arrives in Lincoln. His orders are not to negotiate with the rebels, many of whom have fled at word of his arrival. When it becomes clear that the king will not give in to their demands, the gentry refuse to lead the rebels any further, and the rising collapses. Thomas Kendall, the Vicar of Louth, and Nicholas Melton, Captain Cobbler, are captured and sent to Tyburn to be executed. While in prison, Melton blamed himself for having trusted the local gentry. "What whore sons were we that we had not killed the gentlemen? For I thought always that they would be traitors." The rising at Louth was started by a rumour that the parish church silver was about to be seized. The rumour, when it reached Horncastle, was that this had already taken place. In an age before newspapers, radio, and 24-hour news, word of mouth was the main way ordinary people heard about events. We should be careful, though, before dismissing the rising in Louth as irrational. The parish church may not have been under immediate threat, but the rebels were not entirely mistaken. Smaller religious houses were indeed being closed down, their treasures seized by the king's agents, and the dissolution of the larger monasteries was soon to follow. Nor should we dismiss the Louth Rising simply because it failed. The rebels had still managed the not insignificant feat of raising several thousand men and capturing the city of Lincoln. The Lincolnshire Rising would also inspire, across the Humber in Yorkshire, the Pilgrimage of Grace, the greatest uprising faced by any Tudor monarch. Perhaps the most telling indicator of the significance of the uprising in Louth, though, comes from the impression it clearly made on Henry VIII, who described the county in his letter to the rebels as the most brute and beastly shire of the whole realm.